Hello and welcome to you all in this video lectures series on C programming. We are discussing the loop control statements, which are also known as iterative statements, which are present in C programming language. And in this today's video lecture, we are going to discuss a logic as well as a program to find the entered integer number is palindrome number or not a palindrome number. So let's begin. Consider this program statement. An integer number is taken as an input from user. Write a program to find whether the input number is a palindrome or not a palindrome number. So first of all, we should know the meaning of this word. That is what a palindrome number. A simple and straightforward. Any number is said to be palindrome number when the original number is equal to its reverse number. For example, or in short, I will say number is equal to reverse of number. Okay. For example, if I am going to enter 121 as input, and when I am going to reverse this, say this is my input number and this is suppose the reversed number. When I am going to reverse this, I am getting the same value, right? And this is nothing but what, or this kind of number is called as a palindrome number. If suppose I am going to enter say 3539, when I am going to reverse this number, the output I am going to get is what, 935. So as the input number is not equal to the reversed number, this number is not said to be a palindrome number. So in short, what we are going to do, the logic to check whether the number is palindrome number or not in palindrome number is simple. First, take number from user, reverse this number, okay, and simple, do the comparison between original number and reversed number, right? If the original number and reversed number are same, the entered number is palindrome number, and if the original number and reverse number are different, right, then this is not a palindrome number. A simple and straightforward logic. So for this, again we are going to discuss, right, the logic that is used to reverse the given number. So let's begin. Okay, so first, I am going to declare one variable, say integer variable number, to take a number as an input. To hold the reversed number, the variable rev, which is equal to 0. To separate each digit, I am using a variable, that is rem, and one more variable is there, and that variable is a temp. Right? The use of temp we will find out during the execution of program. Okay, now let us consider, right? So first I am going to write here the logic to reverse the number. So we know that y number should be greater than 0, and now I am going to reverse this number. So rem is equal to number mod of 10. This number is nothing but what, our original number. Okay, that is a number which is taken from user. Rev is going to hold the reverse number, and rem is going to hold the remainder value, that is a separated digit. In short, it's a separated digit. Okay, now number is, rem is equal to number mod 10, then this rev is equal to rev multiplied with 10 plus rem, and then for the next iteration this number is equal to number divided by 10. Okay? So as per the logic, what we say, the input number and the reversed number should be what, same. Then and then only the number is said to be a palindrome number. And if it is not true, means my input number is not same as that of reversed number, this is not a, or the input number is not a palindrome number, right? So let's begin with its execution. Okay, so initially I am going to deal with variable number. So initial, say the value of variable number is 590. Okay, we will first go with the finding the palindrome number. Okay, my first number is say 152, right? So this is number is equal to 152. The REV variable is equal to 0, and REM variable is now going to hold the garbage value. We have not discussed yet the use of this temp variable, because many times when we writing a code, right, so in that case we forget to take any additional variable which is helpful to produce the final result. Okay, now so that's why one line is kept purposefully blank here. So that is going to define the use of temp variable. So I will go with the first execution. Okay, so the first iteration of my execution, REM is equal to number mod 10. Okay, so my input number is what? 152, so divide by this 10. So the quotient value that I'm getting is what? 15, and the remainder value that I'm getting is what? 2 here. Okay, so after first execution, the value of REM is now 2. Okay, then REV is equal to reverse, that is REV multiplied by 10 plus REM. Right now the value of REV variable is 0. So 0 multiplied with 10 plus this 2. Okay, so the result that obtained and assigned to the REV variable is now 2. Okay, and then number is equal to number divided by 10. So 152 divided by 10. So the output that I am getting is what now? 15. So number is now equal to 15. Okay, so this result I am getting after the first iteration. Now move towards the second iteration. Okay, so in second iteration, here the updated value for number is now 15. So as the value of 15 is greater than 0, it will go inside this loop. Now 15 divided by 10, right? So the REM value that I am getting is what? 5, because here simple 15 divided by 10, so the quotient value I am getting as a 1, and the remainder value that we are getting as a 5. And we know that when we deal with this modulus division, the remainder value is extracted, and that is here assigned to this REM variable. So now this 15 divided by 10, the value, the obtained result is 5 now. Okay, so REM is equal to now 5. Then the reverse, that is REV is equal to, now the updated value in previous execution for REV was 2. So 2 multiplied with 10, that is the obtained result is 20. 20 plus 5, the obtained result is a 25. Okay. And then again number is equal to here, right, what this quotient value, that is now equal to 1. Okay, so this is the result that I am getting after the first iteration. Now move towards the third, right? So what will happen in third here? Simple, number, now the result obtained is 1. So as the 1 is greater than 0, remainder is equal to number mod 10, right? So now here 1 divided by 10, so the remainder value that I am getting is 1, and the quotient value is a 0. Okay, so REM is equal to now 1, REV is equal to this 25 multiplied by 10, that is 250 plus 1, so it is a 251, and the number value is equal to now 0, right? So this REV value, that is a reverse number. Now just try to get this, fine. In next, as the value of number is greater than 0, not greater than 0, it is equal to 0, the condition is false, so this loop is not executed. Okay, fine, so it will come out from this loop, right? So our original number was 152, and what we said, the input number and the reverse number, when these two numbers are same, then that is a palindrome number, and when both are different, the number is not a palindrome number, right? So here if you check, my input number is 152, whereas the reverse number is 251. So as both are not same, this input number is not a palindrome number, right? And to print that message, I need to go with this decision control statement. But if I consider here the input number, that is NO as it is, right? If I'm going to write in this way, if NO is equal to REV, okay? Say, this number is palindrome, here I'm going to display the message as palindrome, and else not palindrome. Right, so here we took a number which is not a palindrome number, but while checking of condition, what will happen, the updated value for number is now what? 0. So when it is going to deal with this decision control statement, in that case, the basic task what we are supposed to do here, we have to check this 152 with 251. But unfortunately, instead of using the value as a 152 for a number, as the last updated value for number is 0, the comparison is done with a 0. So here, as the 0 is not equal to reverse number, no doubt I am going to get a not palindrome number. In this case, even my number is not a palindrome number, right? But if suppose I am going to change my input number, suppose my input number is, it's a 151. So what will happen in first iteration? Right here, I am getting the output gate. Let us cross check this. Suppose now again discuss the same. Okay. Say the INT number, the number value is say 151, the reverse REV is equal to 0 and REM variable. Okay, so within a short span of time, let me write it again. While number is greater than 0, REM is equal to number not 10, then REV is equal to REV multiplied with 10 plus REM, and now number is equal to number 10 by 10. And here if number is equal to I'm going to keep this blank, right? If the reverse number and input number are same, the number is a palindrome number, and if this condition is not satisfied, not palindrome. Okay, simple. And which variables we have initialized? The first variable is INT number, then REV equal to 0, then REM, and one more variable, that is a 10th variable, right? So my input number first is, say number is equal to 151, right? So when I'm going to reverse this number, the reverse number that I'm getting is what again? 151, right? But during the execution, first iteration, what is happening? In first iteration, the value of REM 1, REV is again 1, the value of number is what? 51. Okay. In second iteration, what will happen? REM is equal to 5, REV is equal to 15, and number is equal to 1. And in third iteration, REM is equal to 1, REV is equal to 151, and now number is equal to 0. And right now, as the last updated value for number is 0, as this condition is false, directly it will come to this. And what we said, if the input number is same as that of reversed number, okay, the number, or this is specific, or this specific condition going to represent what your palindrome number. And if my input number is not same as that of reversed number, the number is not palindrome number. Like this. Okay, so what is happening right now here? If I'm going to write this condition, what is my condition? If number is equal to REV, because to take the input number, which variable we have used? The number. And many of the times the student mentioned the same, as the input number is number, number is get compared with this reverse number. Right, means this input number, practically what ideally what we are supposed to do, this input number should be get compared with this reverse number. But if I'm going to write this condition for this program, what will happen? The last updated value for number is a 0, right? So even though you are going to mention here as a number, by doing the comparison, 0 is compared with the 151, and as both are not same, the condition is false, and the output that I'm getting is what? Not palindrome number. And for that purpose, here the variable which is present, that variable is a temp variable. So that temp variable I'm using here. So when I'm going to take a number from user, first, before going to process, I'm going to assign the value of this number variable to this temporary variable temp. And what will happen because of that? Here I'm going to take this number, and the same value is assigned to temp variable. So now temp is equal to 151, and for this when I am writing this condition, I am going to mention instead of number, here I am going to mention as a temp, because the temp is going to hold a same value which is entered by the user, and we are not going to alter, we are not going to use this anywhere in this execution. So because of that, whatever the assigned value is there, that is in our case now it's a 151, that remains as it is. So now 151 is get compared with 151, and as both numbers are same, the entered number is a palindrome. So in this way we can find whether the entered number is palindrome number or not a palindrome. Simple, take a number from user, reverse that number and compare the reverse number with the original number which is accepted from the user. So let us cross check this, right? So this is a logic to reverse the number, right? So what we will do now, I am going to deal with one more variable, and that variable is my temp variable, okay? And this assigned value to the input number, that is number is first get assigned to this temp, right? And now if temp is equal to REV, right, what we are going to print, printf enter number is palindrome number, okay. And if the condition is not satisfied, else entered number is not palindrome number. So let us check out this again with a stepwise execution. So initially number is get assigned with some garbage value, REV is equal to 0, remainder 0, temp is assigned with the 16, again some garbage value. So after execution of first, right, this data, we have to write a statement to accept a number from user here. So instead of defining here, once I am going to get value from user, then only I am going to assign that to temp. So now we are waiting for user's response. So the user is going to enter say the first number. The number is say 151, right? So 151, so that number is get assigned to variable number, and the same number will be now get assigned to this temp variable. Here again 151. So as now 151 is greater than 0, first it is going to separate the unit's digit, that is 1. Now 1 multiply this REV, that is 0 multiply by 10, 0 plus 1, the result is 1, and now the REV is equal to 5, okay, and the number divided by 10. So just try to get this, earlier entered value for number is 151, but now it is get changed because of this execution to the 15, but the value that present in a temp, that is in a temporary variable, it remains as it is, okay. So because of that, for the processing purpose or for the comparison purpose, at the end we are using this temp variable, okay. Now the value of number is 0, as 0 is not greater than 0, it is going to first display the reverse number, right? So the reverse number is 151, and okay, it is going to check now the temp, what is the value for temp, it's a 151, and what is the value for REV, it's a 151 again, right? So as this condition is satisfied, entered number is a palindrome number. So here I am getting the result as what, entered number is a, here entered number is a palindrome number, sorry, I forget again to display the value, okay, just wait, let me update the code. Entered number, which is that entered number, it's a TEMP, and again here also, as I have not mentioned the variable name, number is 151 and the entered 151 is a palindrome number. Let us cross check that with some different value. so the reverse number is a 362, and the entered number, that is 263, is not a palindrome. So in this way, we can develop a logic as well as a program to find whether the entered number is palindrome number or not a palindrome number. Simple, take a number, reverse that number, and compare the reverse number with that of original number. If both numbers are same, then simple, I am going to consider that as a palindrome number, and if both numbers are different, then I am going to treat that as a not a palindrome number. Just cross check the spelling for this palindrome. I think it's a PALI. Okay, fine. We'll go with the same. Okay. Thank you.